A particular type of system that we use, deep learning system, is called convolutional network. And that refers to the particular way of connecting the sort of the units or the nodes inside of that neural net. And the way those things are connected is somewhat a little bit inspired by what we know about the architecture of the visual cortex in mammals. The reason for doing convolutions is primarily because objects can appear in a lot of different positions within an image. So if I take a picture of the scissors, you know, I can put it here or here or here, and within the image it's going to be framed in a different location. And perhaps I want my system to also recognize other types of scissors that don't look exactly this way. So for example, if for recognizing this particular scissor, I need a detector for this hole, and you know, I need something that indicates that it's red at a particular place. So I'm going to have a detector for that particular pattern. I want that detector to be applied to the entire image so that wherever the scissor appear, that detector will fire and it will detect that there is this particular shape in the image. And so this idea of having a detector that looks only at a small piece of the image and is repeated everywhere in the image, that corresponds to the operation of convolution. The first layer of a convolutional net is going to have something like 100 different detectors for different motifs. And the thing is, we're not going to build this by hand. Those detectors are going to be trained to detect things that are useful to recognize scissors from other objects or cars from dogs or things like this. It's just part of the learning process that those detectors train themselves to be able to do that distinction. This is what's used almost everywhere for recognizing images, for analyzing pictures, for self-driving cars, for recognizing speech. It's used in certain cases also for understanding text and language.